like to listen to my own voice.
So,
and you?
I am a speech. I run very fast. So fast. You can't catch.
Really? That's so nice. Dances when it rains. Yes. Caw, caw, caw. Hi friends.
Hi.
Hello.
Yeah.
You?
I have a big group of friends.
Oh.
And I love sharing. I never eat anything without sharing.
Good morning, children.
Good morning.
How are you all today?
Fine.
Shall we start the class?
Yes.
So who are we?
Birds.
And what do we do?
Sing.
And?
Fly.
And we also build?
Nest.
Yes. We are made for singing, flying and building nest. Today you are all small, but when you grow up, you will have to fly, you will have to sing and build nest. So would you like to learn to sing?
Yes.
Have you heard your mommy papa singing?
Yes.
Good. I want to teach you singing. I am going to sing and you are going to repeat after me. Okay? Yes, listen carefully.
Coo, coo, coo.
Sing.
Cow, cow, shh.
No, 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 no. This is not how you sing. Cuckoo, would you like to show them how to sing?
Coo, coo, coo.
Very good, cuckoo. Ostrich, you try now.
Good, good, good.
Oh, good, good. No. That's not how you sing. Crow, give it a try.
Caw.
That's how I sing.
Then you're doing it the wrong way. If you sing like this, you'll never be a good singing bird. All the chicks will go back home today, practice singing like the way I have shown you, and come back tomorrow to the class. Okay? Oh God, these chicks, I tell you, I really need a break.
Morning.
Yeah, hi. Morning. How's your day? Don't ask me. I'll be trying to teach the chicks how to sing, and they just can't get a hang of it. I tell you, the crow has been the worst of the lot.
You know what? I have the same problem.
Yeah?
Don't ask me. How much I try these chicks, they just can't follow me. No matter what you do with the peacock, he just can't fly high. Perhaps I tell you, he's not fit for the normal school. He should be sent to the special school.
Yes. Don't tell me. These chicks are very bad. They don't even listen to whatever we tell. We were not like this when we were young. I think we need to report this to the principal.
I have heard about your problems.
I think we need to do something about the situation. Shall we improve the infrastructure and make learning a fun activity? What do you think we can do? Yeah, I think I really need a mic in my class. So when I sing, I'm really loud and the chicks can listen to me and practice singing. I really need a mic.
Okay. Yes, I agree. We make learning a fun activity. So I have thought I'd put few chants in my class so that the chicks can know what our wings and feathers are made up of. And what they should consume to be strong enough. I thought I'll show them few videos also, so that they can learn the technique of flying. Actually, I tell you, a lot of learning is happened through imitations only, right?
Yeah. That seems to be an excellent idea. I think we arrange for the infrastructure.
Yeah, thank you. Oh, it's my class. Oh, bye.
Good morning.
Good morning.
How are you all?
Fine.
You know what? I have really interesting things to show you today. You all like seeing pictures?
Yes.
See, what can you see in this picture?
Birds are flying.
You want to know how birds fly?
Yes.
So let us continue our class of flying?
Yes.
So continue with the last class. What did we learn? We learned birds have feathers and wings that are very important for flying, right? Equally, the tail is also important. Look at your tails. Yes. The tails are very sleek and have fewer feathers on them.
Oh!
Peacock!
I have a question.
What?
My tail is not sleek. It is so long and full of feathers that it falls on the ground. Ostrich actually stepped on it. No, that's why I shocked it.
Peacock! Are you trying to teach me? Are you the teacher or am I? Ostrich, if you don't stop playing pranks with his tail, I will send you out of the class. Now say sorry to Peacock.
Continue
with this in the next class.
Okay.
tell you, no, these chicks, only the crow and the cuckoo know how to fly. They are really very good students.
Good students? Come on, don't tell me that. The other day when I was taking the class, then plastered them how to build a nest. These chicks, you know, especially the cuckoo, she had all the dumb questions. She says she never knows how, she's never seen a nest. Nor she's seen a mom build a nest. And she's very arrogant.
Okay, I agree. Improving infrastructure and teaching aids just seems this cannot help us. We actually need to take better helps. Like, actually this is the age of computers, Googles and YouTube, right? We must make full use out of it, so that the chicks can come up in life, at least to become something in life.
Yes, I do agree. I think we need to better get away with the blackboards. Get Wi-Fi installed in all the classes. And also the projectors wall mounted. It's better we show them educational videos. And then all these things I think should help the chicks better.
Yeah. I think I'll try out the video.
Yes.
It's my class now.
Good morning, children.
Good morning.
Would you like to watch a video?
Yes.
So watch the video. Everyone watch. Did you see the birds singing? Now I want each one of you to try singing. Coming here, okay? We'll start with the crow. Crow, come here. Fast. Fast. Yeah, please sing. Crow. Crow. Oh God, the same thing again. You haven't practiced at home at all.
This is how I sing, teacher.
Shut up. You're not going to talk to me like that. Stretch your wings. Stretch. Stretch. Yes. Go back to your place. Don't giggle. Don't giggle. You're going to be in her place next. Yeah? Just imagine, crow. All your friends are going to go to the next class and you're going to remain here. Will you feel good about it? What will you tell your mommy and papa? Mommy and papa will be happy with you? What not have we done for you, chicks? We have got the projectors wall mounted. We have got a full screen for you. We have got so many educational videos, but no improvement at all. I really think I need to take this up with the principal. Oh, here she is.
Our experienced teachers have tried their level best to straighten out these chicks, but nothing worked out. Now, we have called in experts from various fields to debate on this issue. Can you please tell us what we can do?
I think more money needs to be pumped to improve this board. So let us make flying pigs.
I think we should give them laptops and CDs which they can take home. They can practice at home as well.
That should be included in the syllabus.
Education must be based on evidence and facts. In this scientific era, we must have a scientific approach for teaching. Let us conduct a research on what is causing this problematic behavior in them. What is causing this attention deficit? Why are they not learning?
Okay. Yes, I do agree. I don't think this we have to admit chicks whose mothers are working, because they really don't pay attention at home, and these chicks, they never learn anything.
Let us appoint the counselors, let them talk to the chicks, to the parents, and resolve the personal issues.
How about introducing yoga and meditation, which will improve their focus? Ma'am, I think that's a really nice idea to introduce meditation.
It was decided that researchers from the Harvard University should be invited to conduct studies on the chick's brain. As a result, many papers were published and many books were written. The school became famous, the chicks were taught about their child rights. Some concerned individual advised that these chicks need some time alone. Not understanding what he or she truly meant, an hour of silence and meditation was included in the already overly packed timetable. The only thing the chicks were not allowed was the little thing they so dearly wanted, to be free and to be what they actually are. Whenever they did try to be themselves, they were put back on track and straightened out. In fact, they were looked down upon for being ungrateful and impertinent. Time and again, they were reprimanded. We're doing so much for you, spending so much on you, and you don't even care. Over the years, the little chicks did end up learning a few things, but lost the interest in learning as a whole. They slowly became dependent on the very school system they earlier wanted to break out from. They internalized the fact that the people around them were indeed doing them a favor, that they and their future generations need the support of this wonderful schooling system to be educated. One day, the school ended and the chicks were free. But they were so scared to fly and to sing and to build nests that they feared failure. for they feared judgment, for they feared what others would think about them. They felt comfortable doing what everyone around them did. They basically became one among the crowd. Their dreams were reduced to being a rat in the rat race. In the end, a lot of people made a lot of money on the little bird's education. Everyone benefited except the actual birds.